Thank you. Good afternoon. So, I would like few slides, don't worry, it will be only to support my key messages that I would like to pass you some PowerPoint support. But I would like to give you a real view of what is the role of customer service in the operation and what is the most important today, obviously, is to show you that innovation is a key driver in support and services of our activity. So I will start first to show you something which is perhaps obvious, but we have to have that in mind. Today, we are supporting and providing services to worldwide customers. Customers, this is operators of aircraft, 372, but moving very fast. More than 6,700 aircraft flying worldwide, and all aircraft type from wide body up to the last A380, single L A330 delivered. But our role is really to be there to provide all the support for all those aircraft and all those technologies. And obviously to prepare the future with a strong backlog of Airbus, of aircraft arriving, and especially with a new technology arriving with the SA50, as I will show you that. Every day, more than 20,000 Airbus aircraft are taking off and landing, obviously. This is a big volume of activity worldwide, where we have the mission to provide support and services. We are a worldwide organization. Our customers are worldwide. We must be close to our customers on the daily operation of the aircraft. That's why we have a big team of field rep located close to our customer operation main base, with also some hub of, customer to customer field rep to support our customers. And obviously what is essential in my team of more than 4,000 people, this is a capacity from a cultural point of view to be close to all our customers with all the cultures. Because there is not a single signature of a customer. You have various operations, you have various cultures, you have various way of working, and we have to understand our customers. That's why to have with us more than 50 nationalities to be able to capture this, those expectations, this is key for us. Worldwide location, on training, on warehousing, logistic management, on engineering. We have a worldwide footprint. We have a kind of regionalization approach to be sure that we will be able to be closer and closer to the market. And you have an idea here of our different location from China, Middle East, obviously Europe, India, and America. We are developing those capacity to support a proximity link and to develop a proximity link with our customers. What is our key mission when we are speaking about customer service organization, the function? In fact, I have with my team two missions. The first one clearly is to support the flying aircraft worldwide. And support is to optimize the way our customers are operating the aircraft. Not to forget also to be sure that among our customers we have also the owner of the aircraft. Sometimes the operator are owning the aircraft, but the bank, the leaser, from an asset value point of view, this is one also of our key priority to be sure that those customers, the owner of the aircraft, will be satisfied with the Airbus product worldwide. So support, I will come back on that later on. services. Services, on top of a basic support mission, we are also developing added value services for our customer in four main clusters: upgrades of aircraft, training and ops solution, flight hour services, and material management. At the end of the day, obviously, the key mission is to maximize Airbus and customer value of their fleet during the daily operation and up to the last commercial flight. Our organization, and I will not pass a lot of time on that, but it's important to see that we have a kind of mirror organization of our customers, where we have big blocks which are linked to engineering and maintenance activity of the airline, material management, supply chain, and training and ops side of the operators. And conversely, I have a team working per program, wide body, single L, long range, A380, A350. We start to prepare the arrival of this aircraft. And this team, those teams are working transversally to connect with the upstream organization of Airbus per program. And obviously, we have service and customer support, proximity links, field rep, customer support directors, which are transverse team. A fact which is very important for us: this is a fast-growing fleet of Airbus to be supported worldwide. Here you have the evolution of Boeing fleet and Airbus fleet. It's very interesting to see the pace of growing fleet worldwide, and we will reach 10,000 aircraft to be supported in the coming, let's say, years. It will take us 8 years to come from 6,000 aircraft to be supported worldwide to 10,000. So it's a very fast-growing activity where we have to be innovative enough also to produce the right way to capture the expectation of the customer, but more than the expectation, the flow of data, to be reactive, proactive, and to be extremely efficient with this volume growth. It's one of our key challenges. In the support axis, where we have to be extremely proactive to move our ways of working, new technologies. Obviously, we don't work on a digital aircraft, and more digital aircraft, integrated aircraft, than on the previous generation. The technology is not only the technology of the aircraft, it's also the technology of the environment, the IS system. You will see with some examples that we have to work with the evolution of the media, which is provided today to the worldwide community of engineers, of line mechanics, of pilots. So tablet and things like that, this is something we have to provide solution into that. Extended enterprise, obviously, we are supporting, and we have the integrated responsibility of the aircraft, but the aircraft is built with a lot of suppliers bringing their own structure, system, deliverable, and how to work with this extended enterprise to deliver to the customer a single efficient support. Obviously, A350 and its evolution of technologies, this is one of our challenges. I will come back on that also. Fleet management. Alors, fleet management, it's clearly also a mission which is absolutely important for us, which is to be sure that the cost efficiency, the direct maintenance cost of the operation of our customer, could be permanently optimized, and we must provide solution from scheduled maintenance to unscheduled maintenance to optimize the efficiency of our product. And tailored support. Alors, what is tailored support? It's simply to say that, as I already told you, all our customers are very different. We have not a single model of a customer, from a cargo operator, a charter operator, a low-cost carrier, a flag carrier. small, big operator in fast-growing environment, all that, we have to take in account all that to be sure that we will provide the right approach to our customers. When a customer is operating in a very cold environment, extremely cold environment, these operators, those operators could have different expectation than operators having a very hot environment versus, let's say, their daily operation. And we have to understand that. We have to be able to answer the specific question of those different customers. This is why tailoring the support is absolutely key in the data analysis, in the solution provided. This is one of the areas we are working a lot. Alors, ASP50, just a small zoom on that. Obviously, on top of all the normal deliverable of support organization to provide the documentation, to prepare the training, to prepare all the spare provisioning for our first customers. We have also to be very close to our customer and to provide a very good relationship so that with this evolution of ASP50 technologies, they will take benefit of it from day one of operation. That's why we have started to work with already with customers, the first launching customer. They have, let's say, a representative in our, let's say, support organization through an airline office. We are working with them to work on the tool, to work on the documentation, and so that we manage a smooth transition in their operation for the new aircraft arriving. All that, obviously, is taking account also the evolution of technology. A lot is linked to a new IS way to support those aircraft, but also composite. How to work on composite, which is not a scoop, hein, because composite, since, let's say, ASP10 aircraft certified in 83, we have a lot of composite of aircraft in the aircraft, but now we have more and more, and we have to be sure that those, let's say, technology will be completely and perfectly managed by our customer, from line maintenance to heavy maintenance environment. Health monitoring. Here we see and we are proposing a lot of innovative approach on the system, because health monitoring was something well known in the airline environment for engine monitoring, APU monitoring and things like that. But for a system monitoring, now we are able, with the data recovered, to anticipate, to properly manage a lot of information and to provide efficiency through a good, let's say, data analysis of troubleshooting and to minimize the impact of any failure in operation. So all that, we have a lot of experts working on data management to prepare and to work in real time, in the health monitoring of the aircraft, the Airbus aircraft flying worldwide. And with no distance, because now with the communication means, it's easy to recover the data. An aircraft flying in Australia or in New Zealand, but we could in real time also gather the information, support the airline to help them for this kind of approach. Alors, this was some short example of what in the support side we have to provide, and how we also through those examples show that we move from an innovative approach in processes and things like that. I have not said it was in my chart, and sorry for that. One of the first mission of customer services organization is to be safety contributive and to support the safety operation of our customers. Obviously, we are a part of the loop in the airworthiness process to be able to capture the event and to be sure that the industry and aeronautic process to permanently improve the safety is working properly and capturing the information, being able to detect the event, to analyze all the event is a very contributive factor of our activity to the safety. Now services. Our services, some years ago, end of last decade, IADS has decided to much more promote a service approach through the 2020 vision to say, bon, we are not only a platform manufacturer supporting the aircraft normally, but why with our expertise we must not go, or we must go more in providing more services to our customers, and this is why we have developed this approach to be more efficient to sell some services. Alors, two reasons for that. One, let's be clear, it's business. We see some capacity to sell some services. But on top of that, there is a market expectation also. Some of our customers are asking us, okay, I buy you the aircraft, but I want you to be part of the efficiency of the operation of the aircraft and provide us some services. This is why we have developed this approach, and now based on four clusters, upgrade, training and obsolution, fly by hour, and material services, we are more and more developing this service approach, which has nothing to do against the support role. It's completely complementary. We do not sell what is linked to support, but on top of that, we are able to provide more services to our customers. We see that the market is positively answering to this strategy, and we had a significant growth of this business during the last months and years. And so, in 2011, we have demonstrated that this strategy is very valid. Alors, on the four clusters, some example, material management, which is all the supply chain to be improved and optimized towards the customers, the airlines, and their engineering maintenance department, or the MRO. Obviously, the complexity of the supply chain to be managed to maintain an aircraft, it's very important. There are thousands of references. There are a lot of flow to be managed. There could be big inventory. You have a very complex, perimeter, and we have some customers saying, okay, I want to outsource that. And I want you to optimize for us this supply chain. This is why we have started to propose integrated services in this, inventory management, supply chain management. And we see here on the efficiency we could provide, both sides on the cost to manage such an organization, but also in the inventory efficiency, on the a better planning, a lot of opportunity to have a win-win situation of our customers. This is why more and more we are proposing those services. And obviously, this service to provide an integrated, supply chain, the portfolio of product to be proposed on top of proprietary part, and we have detected that distributing more efficiently worldwide some of the product is key. That's why last year we have acquired a lead company, Sater, in this perimeter, and with this company we are proposing a more efficient global approach to provide this supply chain efficiency to our customers. Fly by hour, essentially on the airframe and the component perimeter, we have seen that with our expertise in the engineering side, configuration management, the way we could improve the troubleshooting of the airline, we are well placed to propose fly-by-hour solution to our customers. And this is why we have started to promote, to sell, to market and to sell, clearly, fly-by-hour packages, customized one, to our customers. And this is a modular approach, where with a customer we could really discuss on which perimeter of their, let's say, component or airframe management they want to have a kind of fly-by-hour contract. And so it's tailored, because versus each customer we could have different views. And this is integrated solution where we have the knowledge to integrate this approach and to provide the relevant service. The clear added value is demonstrated now. We have some key customer where working with them, major one, we have demonstrated that we could drastically improve the operational reliability of the aircraft. We could drastically improve also by our knowledge combined with the airline knowledge, we could drastically improve the downtime for scheduled maintenance and unscheduled maintenance of their fleet. So it's a kind of win-win situation where in this approach we demonstrate really the added value of an aircraft manufacturer to propose those kind of services. Training, flight ops. We have obviously different areas where we provide services. I will not detail what we propose on fuel efficiency, let's say consultancy or a tool, data analysis and things like that. We have a portfolio of services we could sell on those different areas. Training solution, I will come back on that, and flight ops solution. I would like to zoom, because from a high-level strategy with a wide portfolio of product, what is the reality of some of the product? Well, let's take an example which is simple. I'm sure that a big part of you have an iPad or tablet. More and more we have our customers, and in the customer's environment, the pilots, they have their iPad. The airline wants them to work with iPad. And we could provide, and we are providing, and we will start to provide in the coming weeks, for example, performance computation on iPad. And so, on real time, a pilot could compute its aircraft performance. So, the electronic flight bag solution, which are already existing, we are enlarging the scope of it with real time computation of performance. So those kind of, let's say, solutions, which are a little bit a breakthrough in the mindset of an aircraft manufacturer, because to be frank, we are working on an ultra-long-term cycle, development cycle. An aircraft is, let's say, developed and is flying during 30, 40 years, not the same one, but the aircraft type. All those technical solutions, they have absolutely not the same life cycle. And we have to have this approach, which is what could we provide to the customer, which are in line with the evolution of the technology, but also respecting all the constraints or requirements of our aircraft manufacturer business with all the certification requirements. This is why here we are proposing solution where we are able to match the evolution of the technology and respect also what is key, airworthiness, safety, and life cycle, certification, configuration management, traceability, all those kind of things. So this is just an example to show that we are moving permanently now to try to match this evolution of technology and to to be able also to maintain the high level requirement of our industry. Training, another very good example. The training requirement of the airline are obviously, let's optimize more and more the training. Let's be able to take benefit of the latest technology. We are speaking in development now, we are working with 3D mock-up engineering, and now we take benefit in the training, in the documentation, of those 3D mock-up view, of those capacity to propose to the trainee, pilot, engineering, maintenance guys, the best tool to have the capacity to be trained, if possible, and we work a lot close to their main base, because the cost of transporting the team is lower than the cost of transporting some means. And now we are developing those tools to provide an efficient solution to train all those population with the latest, devices and means, which are allowed by the upstream technology of our design office, 3D mockup, essentially. So this is a kind of solution we are now proposing on the market. Another cluster, it's modification of aircraft. The market is not new, but it's more and more. We have to be able to answer the market expectation, the airworthiness evolution, and to be able to modify the aircraft and to provide efficient solution to our customers and to modify the aircraft as soon as their market expectation is changing, or as soon as, for example, for a leased aircraft, you have to, a leaser has to change the operator or want to change the operator, and so the cabin, for example, must be changed. Some system definition must be aligned, and so we have to provide solutions which are efficient from a lead time point of view, obviously from a cost point of view, but also, which is extremely important, from a quality and airworthiness point of view. Because when we modify an aircraft, it's not for 2 years. We must be able to certify this modification and to be sure that for the years to come, decade to come, when the aircraft is operated, we have the full traceability, the full capability to support the airworthiness of the aircraft modified. So this is where we are working to provide all the solution in system modification, in cabin environment, and the cabin is more and more a high level of complexity, because yes, there are seats, there are galleys, there are stowage, but there are also all the video system, capacity of including communication means for the passenger, all that. You could not say, you have got an aircraft 5 years ago or 10 years ago. Those technologies were not existing. And you could not touch the aircraft. So we have to provide and to be able to be extremely reactive, innovative, to find the right solution. But one more time, respecting the requirement of our industry, which is airworthiness, airworthiness, airworthiness. Structure, you see that we have a project which is to implement Sharklet on our single L fleet on short term, and this is also an upgrade of aircraft to improve the efficiency of those aircraft. Alors, clearly, SUAT, first example, we have, already modification of cabin. We work with Qantas. They have started the retrofit of their first aircraft to upgrade the cabin of this aircraft, because they consider that they have to adapt their cabin to the market expectation. With Emirates, we will start to work on the connectivity, so to implement connectivity improvement and capacity to connect through internet inside the aircraft. So all that is, let's say, our, let's say, upgrade capability, and we have to answer the customer. Now here it's easy to speak about SU80, because this is the last aircraft, but when we have the same question for a single aircraft, when we have some requirement from airworthiness to say a fuel inerting system must be implemented in the aircraft, we must be able to provide the capacity to our customer to modify the aircraft. So cabin, well, shortlet retrofit, so we are preparing this retrofit and obviously with the line fit, which will be, let's say, the new aircraft will be delivered with those shortlet, but we will provide the capacity to retrofit the existing single aisle fleet, let's say, in the coming, let's say, months, let's say, probably next year. So, obviously, and the target is to be sure that permanently we could capture the customer expectation. Customer expectation is clear. If you could improve the fuel efficiency of an aircraft, please help us to do that. And so this is why we will be able to propose that very soon. Conclusion, and after I think we have some questions, I'm not too late. Innovation, I would say Airbus, alors it's, I don't know if I have to say old or new aircraft manufacturer. Let's say old one, we have started in 1975, I was a customer during this period, but no. So we are, let's say, an experienced manufacturer, but let's be clear that what we have developed to improve permanently the support and the way of working with the airline, we must not say, we are extremely good, and now let's continue to apply the same processes, the same ways of working, the same approach than the one we have developed during the last decades. If we are not able to permanently move, push our team, push my team to innovate, to be able to capture, to be more efficient versus the customer expectation and the capability of the new technologies, but this kind of arrogancy could kill us. Today, our efficiency is linked to the capability to permanently adapt our way of working support, but also, let's say, services to be provided in a very innovative way. So it's not only a kind of a nice presentation. It's a real challenge to be sure that every day we'll be able to say, what could we do more? Which kind of technology or processes we have to improve? What in the worldwide supply chain, for example? When we started, our customers were close to us. Now, if and when I have, let's say, meeting with Lanchile, when I have a meeting with Qantas, just to give some example, I will not tell them, but you are not in Europe. Bad luck, supply chain performance will be worse than if you would be Air France, Lufthansa, EasyJet, or in US, let's say, operator, which are closer to our, let's say, previous and easy way to supply. So we have really to permanently work and to be sure that worldwide, our performance will permanently improve, and this is why our expertise is permanently to innovate in the way we support and provide service to our customers. That's all.
Thank you, Didier.